I still get most of my work done on a Mac, and in this video I want to share with you 15 applications and utilities that I use to get things done, whether it's recording audio, productivity apps that run in the background like clipboard managers. I'm going to go through a lot of the apps currently running in my menu bar, and I could be wrong, but I bet there's at least a few you have never heard of. And if I miss your favorite Mac app, leave them in the comments below. Subscribe, let's jump into it. First up is PasteBot. This is a clipboard manager that lives in the menu bar of your Mac, and every time you copy something to your clipboard, it saves it up here. You can search all of your past clippings, able to save up to 1,000 clippings, and has other options like filtering over a certain file size. You can enable iCloud sync across your Macs. You can set keyboard shortcuts so you can quickly paste your last 10 clippings, and you can also blacklist certain apps like Keychain or 1Password so your sensitive data is never saved in PasteBot. Now, number two, I'm using this right now, is CleanShot X. CleanShot X is my favorite screen recorder. You can see right now it's running in my menu bar telling me I've been recording for over 8 minutes. CleanShot offers way more tools than the built-in QuickTime recorder, and I find it to be much more reliable. And you can even set clipboard shortcuts to capture the last area if you want to do a still screenshot or video. I use this during Apple events to quickly capture images from the keynote so I can share on social media. And if you do a lot of screen recordings or tutorial style videos, CleanShot X is a must have. Number three is Hazel, this little broom icon here in the menu bar. Hazel runs in the background and you can create rules for moving files back and forth. And one of my favorite features of Hazel is when you delete an app that wasn't installed via the Mac App Store, you can choose to enable app sweep and even multi-user sweep, and it will find all of those files in your Mac library and the application support, and we'll make sure to remove every file associated with that app. For instance, maybe I want to create a rule that every time I take a screenshot, those images are moved to this folder called Screenshots. Well, I can add a folder for Hazel to watch. Here I'm going to have it watching my desktop, and then I'll create a new rule, and I'm going to have two parts to this rule. I want the name to contain screenshot, and the other rule is the file extension is .png. And if those two rules are met, I want Hazel to move the file to the folder that I've now called screenshots. I'll save this rule, and now anytime I take a screenshot, you see I just took a screenshot, it appears down here in the bottom right. You can see it gets saved to my desktop, and Hazel just moved it to my screenshots folder because it followed both of those rules. The word screenshot is in the file name, and it ends in .png. Number four is an app called Pastel. If you work with any kind of color palettes or branding, Pastel is a must-have. You can save color palettes, whether it's for a brand or just colors you refer to often, and they're saved here, and you can copy the hex value, RGB value, and a lot more. Plus, Pastel also has an iPhone and iPad app, so you can build the same collections and they sync between your devices. And a really cool feature is you can take any image, drag it into Pastel, and it will identify the dominant colors, and you can import those colors into a palette. And now you have those hex and RGB values from an image you imported. Number five, this is both a utility on the Mac and an app on my iPhone, and that is Screens Connect. Once you install this utility on your Mac and you set it up, you might have to have some custom settings depending on your network or router. But once it's installed on your Mac, I can have the Screens app on my iPhone or my iPad and then remote into any of my Macs, whether I'm at home on the network or remotely. Then I can control my Mac right here from my phone. There's lots of VNC apps out there, but I've been using Screens Connect for a long time. You can use SSH tunneling for more security, and I find it to be super reliable. Number six, if you've ever heard me talk on a podcast, like my tech podcast, Primary Technology with Jason Aten, you know I use Audio Hijack to record all the audio on my Mac. I'm using it right now to record the audio that you're hearing. And I love Audio Hijack because it's super flexible, lots of different options for building sessions. Right now I have a device input, a level monitoring block, and a recorder. This is creating an uncompressed WAV file. And those levels can actually be here in the menu bar. So even if I'm on a different space here on my Mac, I can still keep an eye on my levels. Plus, there's lots of powerful tools like even live streaming your audio right from Audio Hijack, applying things like an EQ, boosting the volume. And you can also record audio directly from an application on your Mac, as well as audio devices or system audio. Oftentimes, I'll just trigger one of my Audio Hijack sessions from the menu bar. Here I can see that my BT video session is currently running. I've been recording for almost 17 minutes. And you can see I have sessions for my podcast, if I'm doing a Riverside video, and all of that is quickly accessible from that menu bar icon. They did not sponsor this video, but they did sponsor Primary Technology, and so I'll put that link and promo code in the description if you want a discount. And the makers of Audio Hijack also makes an application called Loopback, and Loopback is a super powerful application for routing audio across your Mac. especially if you're working with things like video switchers plus audio interfaces and you're wanting to route that audio to multiple outputs, merge different sources into a single output. Loopback is an incredibly powerful tool, and when you combine Loopback with Audio Hijack, you're basically unstoppable. Number 8, this is a utility for Final Cut that has helped me expedite my chapter process. Now when I'm making a video in Final Cut, I add markers whenever I want a chapter marker. This way I can put that in the YouTube description. Whenever I create a marker, I change it to the chapter style marker, label that chapter, and then once I'm done editing my video, I can go up, export an XML file. This takes just a few seconds. And this utility called Creator's Best Friend, it lives right up here in Final Cut, or you can open just the standalone application. Then you can import that XML file you just exported. And right here, I have chapter timestamps and titles. I can quickly copy this to my clipboard, put it in my YouTube video description, and my chapters are done. I also add regular markers, non-chapter markers, where I want to link videos for when I upload it to YouTube. And so you can browse both the chapter markers, copy those to clipboard, or view other markers. This way you can reference where you want to link those videos. Number 9, you already know, it's Fantastical. Fantastical lives right up here in my menu bar at all times. It's simply the best calendar application. I did an entire video just featuring Fantastical. I'll link it above down in the description. And I'll know exactly where to put that flag in YouTube because I used Creator's Best Friend with the marker. Anyway, it all comes together. If you want to learn more about Fantastical, you can check out that video here. Number 10 is a long-standing Mac utility, which is Text Expander. I use Text Expander for a lot of things, but one of the most recent use cases is for quick ChatGPT prompts. So let's say I transcribed one of my videos, I copy it to my clipboard, then I have a Text Expander snippet, and I do semicolon VGPT for video GPT, and it automatically pastes my prompt asking for a YouTube title, description and tags, and then if I had the entire transcript on my clipboard already, it'll put that automatically after the prompt with a quick Text Expander snippet, and I have a bunch of these I use in ChatGPT to quickly generate ideas, titles and descriptions, and a bunch of things. Next, if you're a podcaster and you want to be able to add chapters and custom chapter artwork throughout your episodes, Forecast is a free app from Marco Arment. I'll put a link in the description. Here I imported the latest episode of Primary Technology, and it automatically brought in my timestamps and custom chapter artwork. But if you didn't already have chapters, you can hit the plus button down here, timestamp for when you want the chapter to change, title that chapter, and then even upload an image. Then you can have that nice custom chapter artwork throughout your podcast. No matter where you edit it, you can put it together in Forecast. Now this next app I can't speak too much about, just because what I use it for, it's... I don't want to say too much. But anyway, Transloader is an application that I run on my iPhone, and it's also running on all of my Macs here in the menu bar. And basically what Transloader does is I can take any link, even if it's just from the share sheet. Here I am in YouTube, I can go to more, and you'll see Transloader is an option. When I tap that app, I can then send it to any of my other Macs, like my Mac Studio. I'll go to my Transloader app, you see it's sending that link to my Mac, and then depending on the kind of link you're sending to your Mac, you can set up different rules and actions, like if the file extension is X, then open it with a certain app, or even run a shortcut based on the link or file that you've sent to your Mac. I'll have to let you imagine the possibilities you can do with Transloader, or you can check out beard.fm because I have a video on it there. Number 13 is a utility that runs in the background. This is called Companion, specifically for Blackmagic ATEM switchers and the Stream Deck. Companion is made by Bitfocus. You access it via IP address. It can look a little complicated, but basically you can add Stream Deck surfaces. Here I have my Stream Deck and my Stream Deck pedal, and then I can program things on my Stream Deck, like switching between cameras, and I can press the button on my Stream Deck, and it switches my ATEM Mini Pro live. I can even switch to a camera and then program picture-in-picture to activate, all from my Stream Deck. Now, yes, I could just move my ATEM Mini Pro to this side of the desk, although that would take a lot of rewiring. What I really like using it for is the Stream Deck pedal that I also have connected to my Mac, and now I can press the pedal, and look, no hands. You can see my video preview here. I can switch between picture in picture and camera one and camera two with my foot. I can even switch cameras and enable picture in picture, all from the Stream Deck pedal, thanks to Companion. All right, and the last two, they're not necessarily apps you install or have to download, but Spotlight, I use it all the time. I've literally been using it to launch some of the apps in this video. And Spotlight is actually incredibly powerful, not only to find contact information, files on your Mac, but also flight and travel information, weather in other locations, and a ton more. I have an entire video on all the powerful features of Spotlight, both on your Mac and your iPhone. I'll link it above or in the description. And of course, number 15, I have to include Shortcuts. Shortcuts lives right here in the menu bar for me, and I have lots of shortcuts I use pretty often, like Apple Frames for screenshots, formatting primary technology show notes, even just accessing iCloud passwords because we don't have a standalone app, quickly convert HTML to rich text, and I have shortcuts for formatting the YouTube video descriptions, both for my channel and Riverside. If you have followed my channel at all, you know I'm a huge Shortcuts guy. So if you want to learn more about Shortcuts, definitely subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, but I'll put a playlist right up here from Shortcuts 101 all the way to Advanced Automations. And I did a recent video on automations and shortcuts to help you save your iPhone battery life. I'll link that below. And apparently YouTube thinks you'll really love this video, so you should check it out. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.